The next topic we are going to discuss in the tree is the Elliott tree. As we discussed the basic concepts of the tree, and we had studied the various different kind of trees. Like in the previous lecture, we have covered the Banerjee's tree. So the another modification of the Banerjee's tree is the Elliott tree. So let's discuss about the Elliott tree. Elliott tree is, we can say, it is a self-balancing Banerjee's tree. Although it is having the property of the Banerjee's tree, but here it is also having the one additional factor that is known as self-balancing, which is invented by the J.M. Adelson Welsky and E.M. Landis in 1962. So Elliott tree is also known as the height balance tree. Means as we insert a node, it keeps on balancing at every insertion, so that the balance factor will always remain the same. Here the balance factor that are possible with every node is either minus 1, 0 or the 1. If any other node has get the balance other than this 3, then the whole tree get rebalanced again to get the balance factor again minus 1, 0 and the 1. So if the tree, within the tree every node is having the balance factor this minus 1, 0 and 1, so we say the tree is a balanced tree. So Elliott tree is also known as the balanced tree or the height balanced tree, so that the rebalancing is taken place at every stage with every insertion, every deletion, with every operation over here. So we can the balance factor is interpreted in which the height of the two subtree of the node may differ by at most one. Height of the two subtrees. Two subtree means if you take the left subtree and if you take the right subtree, then the difference between the two, the left and the right, can be either minus 1, 0 or the 1. How it is calculated? We'll discuss. So the advantage of using the Elliott tree is that it takes order of log n time to perform searching, insertion and the deletion. In the average case as well as in the worst case. So as we have seen in the case of the Banerjee's tree, we have seen that in which the insertion, deletion and the searching is taking the order of log n time. But if you talk about the left skew tree or the right skew tree, in that case the searching will take, or the insertion and the deletion will take order of n time. So that is a special case of the Banerjee's tree. So in that case the worst case time of the Banerjee's tree can be order of n. But in case of the Elliott tree, in the average case as well as in the worst case, the time complexity will always remain the order of log n. So that's why Elliott tree is the best example or the better way to represent the data here. So Elliott tree is the same as the Banerjee's tree. As I told you that Elliott tree is the same as the Banerjee's tree. Only the difference is here that in the structure is that we store the variable called balance factor with every node. So every node has the balance factor associated with it. Now how we calculate the balance factor? The balance factor is calculated by that we calculate the height of the left subtree, and from that we deduct the height of the right subtree. First we calculate the height of the left subtree, then we deduct the height of the right subtree. If we get the balance factor as 1, means it is, if it is a positive, then we say that the left subtree is one level higher than the right subtree, and it is called the left Elliott tree. For example, in the left subtree we are having the 3 level, in the right subtree if you have the 2 level, so we will get the positive value 1 over here. So we can say that the left subtree is 1 level higher than the right subtree, and the tree will be called the left Elliott tree. If the balance factor is 0, in which the height of the left subtree and the right subtree is same, so there is no such difference, so that's why balance is 0. And if you get the balance factor as a minus 1, so in that case the height of the left subtree is 1 level lower than the right subtree. So right subtree is having a 1 level higher than the left subtree. So in that case the difference we get is a minus 1. So these are the 3 variations or the 3 values can be there of the balance factor. Okay. Now here we talk about the some of the operations of the Elliott tree. Let's first operation, if we talk about the search. Let's say if you want to search any element, before going with that, let's look at the one of the example of the inventory. By that, it will get more clear that what is the balance and how it is calculated here. Let's say that suppose we have inventory 45, 36, 63, 27, 39, 54, 72, 70. Suppose this is the GST we are given. As we see, we can see all the data is arranged in the form of the that all the value less than the root are left, all the value greater than the root are at the right subtree. So same structure is here. Now here is the grid said that one additional variable is available, that balance is available with every node. We calculate the balance factor here. So all the nodes which are available at the leaf level are having the balance value 0. So here we get the balance value 0 for this. Now we calculate the balance factor of the internal nodes. So balance factor is, let's say, for the 36. So 36 having one left child, one right child. So height of the left subtree, height of the right subtree. Both of these is 1 and 1. So 1 minus 1, you will get the 0. Now for the 72, 72 is having only one left child but does not have any right child. So here we can say the difference is 1 minus 0. So here we will get the balance 1. Now for the 63. 63 is having only one height of the one left child, but at the right side of the 63, we are having the height of the right subtree is 2. So in that case, the difference we will get is 1 minus 2, we will get the difference minus 1. Balance is minus 1. Now for the 45. Now for the 45, at the left subtree, what is the maximum height at the left subtree? 2. What is the maximum height of the right subtree? 3. So that difference will get minus 1. So by this we calculate the balance factor of every node. So in this case we can say that the node is having the balance factor either 1, minus 1 or 0. So that's why this is the example of the AVA tree in which all elements are balanced. Other tree is balanced over here. Now in this, if you have to perform the searching of, let's say if you talk about the some basic operations that you can perform over the AVA tree. So first operation we talk about the searching. Then if you want to search any element within the AVA tree, so the searching is the same as we have seen in the binary search tree, that every time we start from the root, compare the element that we are searching with the root. If it is equals to root, that means we have got the element at the root itself. But if the element that we are searching for is less than the root, so we will follow the left subtree. If the element that you are searching is greater than the root, then you will follow the right subtree. So there is no such variation in the searching of the AVA tree and the binary search tree. So we can go through with that. Now another operation that we can perform over here is the insertion. How we will perform the insert operation in the AVA tree? Now when we perform the insert operation in the AVA tree, the insertion is done in the same way as the binary search tree, that whenever the new node is inserted, it will again compare with the root node. If it is less than the root, then we will follow the left. If it is greater than the root, we will follow the right. And the new node is inserted in the form of the leaf node at a tree. It is the same as the binary search tree, it is the same as the AVA tree, that the new node will be added in the form of the leaf node. Now whenever we are inserting a new node in the AVA tree, we have to calculate the balance factor of all the nodes from that newly inserted position to the root, means all the nodes which are available in that path from the newly inserted node to the root node. Because by the insertion of the new node, the balance factor of all the nodes within that path from that new node to the root will get changed. So every time we need to calculate the balance factor of those node within that path. Now by insertion of the new node, if the tree remains balanced, means if the node is having the value either minus 1, 0 or the 1, So it does not need to do anything. It is the insertion is the same as we are inserting in the binary search tree. But if by the insertion the valence vector of those node get changed, and our tree is not now in the AVL tree format, so in that case we have to perform the rebalancing of the tree. So how the rebalancing will take place? It depends on that how where we have inserted the new node. It depends on the position of the newly inserted node. Based on that, the rebalancing of the tree will take place. Let's look at the example that how the balance vector will get changed by the insertion of a new node. Let's if we take the same tree, and in that tree, if you are inserting 30, that is insert 30. We are inserting 30 over here. So the 30 will be inserted in the left of 45, left of 36, and here we will insert 30. The 30 will be inserted over here at this position. Now here calculate the valence vector of all the nodes again. Or which node will get affected? The node which are in the path from this newly inserted node to the root, means 27, 36, and 45. All this node valence vector will get affected, not for the others. Okay. Now let's calculate the valence vector. Here for the 30, as it is a leaf node, the valence vector will be 0. For the 27, as 27 does not have any left child but having the right child, so valence vector will be minus 1, left minus right, so minus 1. Now the valence vector of 36. Now for the 36, the left child is having the 2, right is having only 1, so valence vector will be the 1. And for the 45, now the left subtree, height of the left subtree is 3, height of the right subtree is 3, so valence vector will get 0. So here, now still our tree is in the balance form, so we does not need to perform the rebalancing. Only the balance vector of the nodes will get changed. Now let's say that, suppose we take the original one, this is 0, this was 0, and this was minus 1. Now let's say instead of inserting 30, let's say I am inserting insert 71. Now insert 71. So where the 71 will get inserted? Right of 45, right of 63, left of 72, and right of 70. So 71 will get inserted here in the form of the binary search. Now again calculate the valence vector. For the 71, the valence vector is 0. For the 70, as 71 is the right child but does not have any left child, so we will get the balance vector minus 1. Now for the 72, it is having only height of the left subtree is 2 but it does not have any right subtree, so balance vector is 2. The balance vector for the 63, here left is 1, right is 3, so minus 2. And for the 45, the left subtree maximum height is 2 and the right subtree maximum height is 4, so we will get the balance vector minus 2. So here you can see that now by inserting a new node, the balance vector of all the nodes within that path are changed, and now it is other than the minus 1, 0 and 1. Now it is 2, minus 2 and minus 2. So now our tree become unbalanced by the insertion of this node. So in this case, we need to perform the rebalancing of the tree. Now whenever we are performing the rebalancing, we have to first find out that the critical node. Whenever we have to perform the rebalancing, first we have to find out the critical node. Now which is a critical node? Critical node is that the nearest ancestor of the newly inserted node which is having a balance factor other than the minus 1, 0 and the 1. A nearest ancestor of the newly inserted node within the path from that node to the root node which is having the balance vector other than the minus 1, 0 and the 1. So in this case, the nearest ancestor having the value balance vector other than this is 72. So in this case, we got the critical node is 72. Now the second thing we have to perform is the rotation. Now, which kind of the rotation will be performed? It depends on the position of the newly inserted node with respect to the critical node. Which kind of the rotation will be performed? It is based on the position of the newly inserted node with respect to the critical node. So they are the four kind of the rotations are there. Here you can see. The first case is that if the newly inserted node is on the left subtree of the left subtree of the critical node, as I told you that you have to find the position of the newly inserted node with respect to the critical node. So if the newly inserted node is on the left subtree of the left subtree of the critical node, so that kind of rotation is called the LL rotation. That is left of the critical node. And the newly inserted node is in the right subtree of the critical node, so that kind of is called the RR rotation, LL and RR. So when we are having LL and RR rotations, in that case we have to perform only one rotation. A single rotation will be there. Now other cases are, case 3 is that if the newly inserted node is on the right subtree of the left subtree of the critical node, it is on the right of left of the critical node. Let's say that this is the critical node, it is on the right subtree of the left subtree of the critical node. Let's say this is the newly inserted node, it is on the right subtree of the left subtree of the critical node. It is on the right of left of critical node. So that kind of the rotation is called the, it is on the right subtree of the left subtree. So that is called the LR. Right subtree of the left subtree of the critical node. Second is that a insertion is done on the left subtree of the right subtree of the critical node. So in this case, it is on the left subtree of the right subtree of the critical node. So it is called the RL rotation. Left subtree of the right subtree of the critical node. So there are the four kinds of rotation, LL, RR, LR and RL. So when we are having the LR and RL, so in that case we have to perform the two rotations. In LL and RR, single rotation. But in the LR and RL, we need to perform the two rotations. Let's look at with the every other rotation. This is the first case, the LL rotation. In the LL rotation, let's say that this is the root node, the K2. This is another node, K1. Now in the K1, this was the initial position of the A and B are on the same level. Now when we have inserted one more node here, so in this case the balance factor of the K1 become +1, balance factor of K2 become the +2. Now the balance factor of the K2 become change. It is not in the -1, 0 and 1. So in this case we have to perform, so where this new node is inserted into the left subtree of the left subtree of the critical node. Now the K2 is the critical node. And where we inserted, it is on the left subtree of the left subtree of the critical node. So we have to perform the rotation towards the right. So this whole thing is rotated towards the right. So the, in that case, the K1 will become the root, K2 will become the right child of the K1, and this B child, which is initially now the right child of the K1, will become the left child of the K2. So here you can see, when we perform the rotation, the K1 becomes the root, K2 becomes the right child of the K1, and B, which is initially the right child of the K1, was now become the left child of the K2. And now calculate the balance factor. So K2 is having the balance factor 0, K1 is having the balance factor 0. So again now the tree becomes the balanced. Let's look at the example of this. 45, 36, 63, 27, 39, 54, 72. to suppose this is the initial ability is given to us. In this the balance factor is this, the tree is balanced. Now in this tree we have to insert a new node 9. So based on the property of the BST, the 9 will be inserted over here. So when we insert the 9 over here, it's now calculate the balance factor. Now is 9 is enter this node, balance factor of 9 is 0, balance factor of 18 will become 1, balance factor of 27 will become 2, balance factor of 36 again become 2, as the height of the left factor is 3, right is 1, so it having the balance factor 2, and the balance factor of 45 again become 2. So here you can see our tree become unbalanced by the insertion of the 9. Now we have to find the critical node first. Which is the critical node? The nearest ancestor having the balance other than it. So the 27 is the critical node. Now, what is the position of the newly inserted node with respect to critical node? That is on the left subtree of the left subtree of critical node with respect to 27. So we have to perform the rotation towards the right. So how the rotation will take place? When we perform the rotation, so 18 will become the root. So here we will get the 18. The 27 will came over here, and here we will get the 9. So things, the nodes are rotated towards the right. So now the 18 become miss. Which is the next node with respect to the critical node in the descendant? That will come to the root position, and that critical node will become the right child of that. So 27 come to the right side and 18 come over here. Now calculate the balance factor again. So this is 0, 0, 0. Here you will get 1, 1. So now our tree is again balanced. Take one more example.
Will become the left side of the 45. So 39 came out.
Now we have tripled the balance circle. So this is 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, and 0. So now what we will get? Balance again. So this way we can perform the LL rotation. Now take the next case. Now the RR rotation. In the RR rotation, here you can see this is the tree initial, the K2. In the K2, we have inserted one node here. So balance factor of K2 become minus 1, here the one level is higher, B and C. So the balance factor of K2 is minus 1. Then the balance factor of K1 become minus 2. So the K1 becomes a critical node. Now here, the position of the newly inserted node is on the right subtree of the right subtree of the critical node. So in this case, we need to rotate the whole tree towards the left. So when we rotate it towards the left, the whole tree gets balanced and we get the, again the balance factor in the form of 0, 1 and the minus 1. Let's look at the example. Here 45, 36, 63, 37, 39, 54 and 72 and 89. This is the initial tree is given to us. Let's assign the balance factor with every node. So the balance factor is like this. So this is the initial position and our tree is balanced over here. Now within this tree, let's say if we are inserting a new node 91. According to the property of the BST, the newly inserted node will come at the this position 91. Now again calculate the balance factor of every node. So in this case, the balance factor of 91 is 0. 89 will get minus 1. 72 will get minus 2, and 63 will again get minus 2, and 45 will be the minus 2. So here you can see the now that the balance factor of all the nodes within the root from within the path from the newly inserted node to the root has been changed, and now our tree becomes the unbalanced. Is they are having the balance factor other than the minus 1, 0 and the 1. So in this case, first let's find the critical node. So critical node is the nearest ancestor having the balance factor other than this. So it is 72 is a critical node. Now in this, find the position of the newly inserted node with respect to the critical node. So newly inserted node is on the right subtree, on the right subtree of the critical node. So we are performing the RR rotation. So in the RR rotation, what we do, we perform the rotation towards the left. So in this case, the next node with to the critical node is become the root and the tree is rotated towards the left. So 89 will come over here in place of 72. This is 89. 72 came over here and in place of 89 we will get 91 and the tree become like this. Now we calculate the balance factor. So this is 0, 0, this will become 0, this is minus 1, this is minus 1. So here you can see our tree again get balanced. Look at the next example. 45, 36, 63, 54, 72. Suppose this is the tree, the balance factor is given like this. is a balanced tree. Now let's say within this tree we are inserting a new node 89. When we insert the node 89, it will come over here. Now again calculate the balance factor of every node. So 89 is 0, 72 minus 1, 63 minus 1, 45 minus 2. Right? So what we get? Unbalanced. And which is the critical node? At the root node. So in this case, 45 is a critical node. The position of the newly inserted node is in the right subtree of the right subtree of the critical node. This is the complete right subtree of the right subtree of the critical node. So we have to perform rotation towards the left. So after the rotation, the 63 means the next node of the 45 will come to the at the position of the root. 63 come over here. 45, 72, 89. Then 36, came over here. Then 54, which is at present the left child of the 63, will become the right child of 45. 54, came over. Again, the balance factor 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 0. And our tree get balanced. So this is the RR rotation. Now take the third case. This is the LR rotation, in which it had told you that we didn't need to perform the double rotation in the LR and RL. So in the LR rotation, let's say this is the initial tree given. Let's we inserted a new node in the K2. So K2 is having the balance factor this, K1 is having the balance factor minus 1, but the K3 is having the balance factor plus 2. Now in this, we need to perform the two rotation. And now what is the position of the newly inserted as K3 is a critical node? What is the position of the newly inserted node? It is on the right subtree of the left subtree of the critical node. We'll read like this. It is on the right subtree of the left subtree of the critical node. It is on the right subtree of the K1, on the left subtree of K3 of the critical node. So now the two rotations will be there. One rotation will be between K1 and K2. So K2 will come on place of K1 and K1 will become the left child. Then another rotation will be between K2 and K3. So K2 can. So when we perform the rotation between K1 and K2, it like this. K2 come in place of K1, and K1, which is at present the parent of the K2, will become the left side of the K2. So it comes like this. This is the first rotation we have performed between K1 and K2. Then the second rotation is performed between K2 and K3. So now the rotation is taken place. So K2 come as the root, and the K3, which is at present root, will become the right side of the K2. So it like this. So two rotations are there between K1 and K2, then K2 and K3. And our final tree will be like this. So that's why it is called the LR rotation, that is on the right subtree of the left subtree of the critical node. Let's look at the example. Initially, the balance factor is this one. Let's say I am inserting 37. Let's say I am inserting 37 in this. So 37 will be inserted here. So by inserting a 37, now calculate the balance factor. 37 is 0, 39, 1, 36, minus 1, and 45 is 2. Now 45 becomes the critical node. Right? Now, What is the position of the newly inserted node with respect to critical node? It is on the right subtree of the left subtree, right subtree of, this is the right subtree of 36 and the left subtree of 45. So it is on the right subtree of the left subtree of the critical node. Right? So we need to perform LR rotation. Right subtree of the left subtree of the critical node. So LR rotation is here. So now we need to perform the two rotation, one rotation between 36 and 39. So it will become like this, 45, 63. Now when we perform the rotation between 36 and 39, so 39 come over here, 39, 36, 27, and 37, which is at present the left side of the 39 will become the right side of 36. This is the first rotation between this. This is the first rotation. Then another rotation between 39 and 45. So it become 39, 45, 63, 8 becomes like this. 39 comes at the root, 45 will become the right side of the 39, and 3 becomes like this. So second rotation. Now calculate the balance factor only. And our 3 becomes the balanced. So in case of the LR rotation, we need to perform the two rotation here. Take another case, RL rotation. In the RL rotation, we inserted a node in the form in the K2, and now calculate the balance factor. So in this case, the balance factor of the K1 become minus 2. So K1 is critical node. Now the position of the newly inserted node with respect to critical node is, it is on the left subtree of the right subtree of the critical node. It is on the left subtree of the K3 and the right subtree of the K1. So we will read the left subtree of the right subtree of the critical node. So that's why it is called the other rotation. It is on the left of right of critical node. So now again we need to perform the two rotation. One rotation between the K2 and K3. So it rotated like this. So K2 come over here at the top. K3 will become the child of the K2, and the C, which is at present the right side of the K2, will become the left side of the K3. So here it is. This is one rotation between the K2 and K3. Now the second rotation between the K2 and K1. So K2 come at the top. K1 will become the left child, and K3 is like this. So our thing get balanced. So in this case again we need to perform the two rotation between the K2 and K3, then K2 and K1. Let's look at the example for this. Now in this, insert a new node 60. When we insert a new node 60 in this, so 60 will be inserted on the position here. 60 is inserted over here. Now we'll get the balance structure again. So this is 0 minus 1. This remains 0. This will be the 1 and this will become minus 2. So now 45 is the critical node here. It become unbalanced. Now in this, find the position of the newly inserted node with respect to critical node. So the newly inserted node is on the left subtree after right subtree of the critical node. It is on the left subtree of the right subtree of the critical node. So again we need to perform the two rotation in this. So one rotation will be between the 54 and 63, and another rotation will be the new direction. So let's perform the rotation. So the newly position will be like this: 45, 36. Now when we perform the rotation between 54 and 63, the 54 will become the root. Then 60, which is at present the right side of the 54, will become the left side of the 63. So new position is like this after the first rotation. Now then perform the another rotation. Now the another rotation between the 54 and 45. So 54 come at the root, 45 is here, 36 is here, then 63, then 60, then 72. Now calculate the balance factor: 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0. So our thing get balanced. So we did first you perform the first rotation, then the second rotation. First rotation is between 54 and 63. Then second rotation is between 54 and 45. So 54 will become the root like this. So these are the RL rotation. So these are the four rotations that we need to perform with the insertion of the any node. Only two cases that if the tree get unbalanced. But if by the insertion, if the tree remains balanced, then we does not need to perform any kind of rotation. The cases can be there that suppose our tree is the left heavy tree or the right heavy tree, and if we inserted a node, then by the insertion of the node the tree get balanced. Means if the tree is left heavy tree and we inserted node in the right subtree, so tree get balanced. Or if the tree is right heavy tree and we inserted node in the left, so tree get balanced. So we does not need to do the rebalancing. Or if the tree is balanced and we inserted node in the left or the right, so tree become either the left heavy or the right heavy. So we does not need to do anything. We does not need to perform the rebalancing. And the third case is that if the tree is left heavy and we inserted node in the left side, so tree become unbalanced. Or if the tree is right heavy and we inserted node in the right side, so tree become unbalanced. So in that case, we need to perform the rebalancing. Now the next operation that we perform in the tree is the deletion. Now when we perform the deletion with this, then by the deletion also our tree may get unbalanced. Initially if the tree is balanced and we perform the deletion either from the left or the right, so tree may become either the left heavy or the right heavy. But if the tree is already left heavy and we perform the deletion from the right, so tree become unbalanced. Or if the tree is right heavy and we perform the deletion from the left, so tree become unbalanced. So in that case, we need to perform the rebalancing. Now when we perform the rebalancing, so it depends on the what kind of the deletion we perform. If you perform the deletion from the left, so we have to perform the L rotation. If you perform the deletion from the right, so we have to perform the rotation, we have to perform the right rotation. Let's for example, let's suppose we are deleting a node X from the tree. And by deletion of the node X, if a node A becomes the critical node, suppose this is the node A, and if you perform the deletion of a node X, then by deletion of node X, if A becomes the critical node, now what is the position of the X with respect to A? Means we are talking about only the critical node whose balance factor become other than minus 1, 0 and 1. So by deletion of X, if X becomes the critical node, so the position of the X with respect to A is that X is on the left subtree of A. So we will perform the L rotation. If the position of X with respect to the critical node is the right, then we perform the right rotation, R rotation. So this L and R rotations are there. Now again, within this, if we are having R rotation, so R rotation is having on three types, R0, R1 and R-1. In the same way, if you are having L rotation, so it is same as L0, L1, L-1. So let's discuss about the only R. L is the same as the mirror image of the R. So let's talk about the R rotation in the division. Let's say we talk about R0 rotation. Suppose the tree is given to us 45. 36, 63, 72, 27, 39, 40, 50. Suppose this is the tree, initially the balance factor is like this. Is the balance factor. Our tree is balanced at present. Now from this tree, let's say I want to delete a 72. When I delete the 72 from here, now calculate the balance factor. 63 will become 0 and the 45 having the balance factor 2. Our tree become unbalanced. When the tree is unbalanced, now 45 is the critical node. So which node we deleted? We deleted a node from the right of the critical node. So we are performing the R rotation. Now in this, check the balance factor of the next node at the left of the critical node. We deleted the 72 from the right of the 45. So 45 become the critical node. Now calculate the balance factor of the node which is just next at the left of the critical node, 36. Now 36 having the balance factor 0. So in that case we perform the R0 rotation. So this R0 is computed by this, that the balance factor of the 36 is 0, which is at the left of the critical node. So R0 rotation is there. So in this we perform the rotation and the new tree will be like this, 36, 45, 63, 27, 18, 39. The tree will go like this. So 39, which is at present the right side of 36, will become the left side of the 45. Like this. Now we'll get the balance factor. This is 0, minus 1, 0, 1. So how do we get balanced by this? So this is called the R0 rotation. Now take the R1. Suppose this is the initial tree is given to us. Let's calculate the balance factor. This is the R1 rotation. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 2. 15, 15, 15, sorry. One more node is here. This is 72. 0, minus 1, and 1. Suppose this is the initial tree is given to us. Now from this tree, let's say again I am deleting 72. Now from this tree, if I delete the 72 again, so now the new balance factor is calculated like this. 63 is 0, 45 is having the balance factor 2. So our tree get unbalanced by the deletion of the 72. Now the node that we deleted was on the right subplane of the critical node. So we perform R rotation. Now which kind of R rotation will be there? So calculate the balance factor of the next node of the critical node in the left subplane. So it is having a balance factor 1. So we perform the R1 rotation. 72 was on the right subtree, so we perform the R rotation with respect to critical node. Then check the balance vector of the next node in the left subtree of the critical node, that is 36, same the balance vector 1, so we perform the R rotation. So after the rotation, the tree becomes like this: 36, 45, 63, 27, 18. The tree becomes like this. Now the balance vector. Trigger balance tree. By this rotation. This is the R1 rotation. Now take the another one. R minus 1. R minus 1 rotation is like this. Just take the tree first. 45. 3, 72, 36, 37, 41, 39, 41, 36. Suppose this is the initial tree is given to us, the balance vector will be created like this. 0, minus 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, minus 1. So initially the tree is balanced. Now from this tree, let's say I am again deleting 72. If I again delete the 72, the balance vector become like this. 0 and it become. Now, as we deleted the 72 from the right of the critical node, 45 is the critical node now, so with respect to the critical node, we deleted a node from the right side of this, so we will perform the R rotation. Now, which kind of R rotation? So, take the balance vector of the next node at the left of the critical node, that is 36, having the balance vector minus 1, so we perform the R minus 1 rotation. Now, when we perform the R minus 1 rotation, we need to perform the two rotations over here. One rotation between 36 and 39, and another rotation will be 39 and 45. So, take the first rotation, 45, 63, 39, 36, 37. This is the case, 36, 39 is here. Then, 37, 41. This is the first rotation we perform. 41, which is at the right side of 39, will become the right side, but 37, which is at the left side of 39, will become the right side of the 36. So that will become like this. This is the first rotation we perform between 36 and 39. Now the next rotation is between 39 and 45. So it will be like this. 39, 45. 63, 36, 27, 37, 37. The next rotation is between 39 and 45. So 39 will become the root and the tree becomes like this. Now we'll put balance vector. So our tree becomes balanced. So in the R minus 1 rotation, we need to perform the two rotations. The two rotations is like this. And we will get the finally a balance tree. So this is a complete about the AB tree.